What comes to mind upon seeing these curious stone structures? Unique to Albirobello in the Apulia region of southern Italy are these conical Trulli houses, completely made of stone that date back to the 15th century. Back then, there were almost 3,500 Trulli houses. Today, there are only a handful left, but it's still a sight to see. Many Trulli houses still belong to their original owners, but have now been transformed into shops and restaurants. Domenico and his two sons, Luca and Marco, transformed their family home into Ristorante L'Aratro some 31 years ago. Domenico is proud to serve traditional Apulian recipes at L'Aratro. The restaurant is a member of the slow food movement, and Domenico is a firm believer in Kilometro Zero. There are probably more pasta shapes than there are dialects in Italy. Here in Puglia, the most common are fricelli, cavatelli, cavatellucci, and the most famous, orecchiette, or little ears.
Okay, I'm gonna try to make the fricelli now. Okay.
Ok, adesso no, no, basta così. Adesso con tutte e due le mani va avanti.
Bravissima, brava.
Ok, un po' corto?
Bene, no, no. E si è attaccato un po'.
Ok, cut. Un'altra volta.
Un'altra volta.
It looked so simple with Caterina doing it, but it's really tough to do. It's a lot about timing. If you don't do it fast enough, it sticks to this. So I'm gonna try again. Okay. Now they're going to show me how to make orecchiette, which is going to be very challenging, but I'll try. Cut a piece of the dough with a knife on your right hand, but you, così, no?
Sì, sì, sì. Okay.
Push. Un'altra volta, un'altra volta.
Perfetto, perfetto.
No, dai.
Dai, è venuta bene, guarda che bello, dai.
Non è un'orecchia.
È un'orecchia,
pensa questa. I said it's not an ear.
The pasta is brought to the kitchen where Marco is waiting to cook them, using recipes he's known all his life. Orecchiette con cime di rapa is the most classic pasta dish in the region of Apulia. Like the best Italian recipes, it's a simple dish with very few ingredients. There's a reason why the orecchiette is shaped like little ears. This is so that it scoops up more of the sauce.
Grazie di cuore. Domenico says he opened his home together with Marco and Luca and his better half, his wife. It warms our hearts because we can feel l'amore da voi. Grazie. Cin cin.
Oh, scusami, cin cin.
A few kilometers from Alberobello, also in Puglia, is the sleepy town of Altamura. Here are three dynamic things about Altamura. One, the town forced a giant global fast food chain out of business. After realizing that the locals still preferred their own bread, the fast food chain closed shop and quietly left town. 2. Altamura is the home of the first Italian bread to be given DOP status or protected designation of origin. 3. In a small town like Altamura, there are over 58 bakeries. Panetteria Petronella is one of the 58 bakeries in Altamura And there is always a line. Pane di Altamura, or the bread of Altamura, is not a dainty or pretty kind of bread. It's quite the opposite. It's huge, with the weirdest shape and the hardest crust. The original pane di Altamura was a giant of a bread weighing 3 kilos. Today, bakeries like Petronella bake them in 1 kilo sizes. Michele and I chat about what else they bake. He tells me about their pasticcio and focaccia and make it sound so delicious that I ask if he would be willing to show me how they're done. Without hesitating, he leads the way back to the work table. Together, we make pasticcio, a savory pie of bacala, onions, anchovies, and olives.
He says that every bite of the pasticcio is different because it has different amounts of cod, different amounts of onion, and different amounts of olive with every bite. So each bite is a different flavor. Isn't that amazing? Just from this little one focaccia.
The same dough is used for the pane di Altamura, the pasticcio, and the focaccia. It's just the amount of olive oil, the handling of the dough, and the amount of time for each to rise that differs.
Look at how it's risen so much, and then look, crunchy on the outside, but I can eat. Ooh!
Hai visto?
Yeah. Yeah. That's it! There you go!
Buono.
Okay.
Prego.
Grazie.
Cin cin.
Vito, Paolo, and Angelo, now known as the Burrata brothers, have traveled far and wide, both to unleash their wanderlust and to spread the gospel of cheese. But no matter how far they go or how long they stay away, they have always returned to Altamura and their beloved Caseificio. Burrata originated from the Apulian city of Andria, not too far from Altamura, in the early 1900s. It slowly gained popularity within the region, and recently it has become a hot item in many restaurants around the world.
I think you can make good burrata everywhere in the world. You just need the right milk, the happy cow, because we keep working on these.
The happy cow.
Only a happy cow can produce good milk, which is essential in making a good burrata.
This is like the mozzarella. This is the same curd. We just stretch it.
Ah, okay.
Like that, and we add that to our cream. Okay, so right so here.
Stracciatella swimming in cream.
Yeah.
The sack with the stracciatella and the fresh cream is sealed and put in a water bath. Customers come for traditional cheeses like burrata and caciocavallo, but lately, they've been curious about their other creations.
Cheese is not a museum, it needs to evolve.
That's true.
I notice there is a focaccia on the table. And when I look closely, I recognize it from Panetteria Petronella. How cool is that? Before I could ask Vito why there's focaccia, he tells me a story.
When I was going to school, when everyone had been eating like a brioche, my father was preparing me this with burrata on top. You know, the little kids, they were starting laughing at me. But then I make them try it, and I was bringing this for all the school. And all
after
the
a while, you were yeah. giving it to yeah. all of them? Oh my gosh.
And then I understand why we have a focaccia. Vito has thought of something wild to reinvent the focaccia.
I go?
Yeah, go.
Sure.
Whoa! Ah! Oh my god.
This
now that's a Vito classic.
Yeah, this is like a classic.
And it was also quite good. Now, all I have to do is look for some happy cows.